guys, today I'm here with a fashion haul, but this time it is with a sustainable brand and an ethical brand. I'm not really sure what you call them. Like, I guess sustainable is probably the best word. It's kind of like all encompassing. I did a call out on my Instagram the other day asking for brands that you'd like to see featured in a clothing haul, and sustainable brands were really, really highly requested. So I did some searching and found, I'm having some trouble finding brands that I not only like the clothing style, but are actually very openly sustainable, and like it isn't just a marketing ploy, like I can really believe in it, and also that isn't exorbitant. Like I can't justify spending $200 on a plain sweatshirt, even though I know it's obviously got like a better history. I just physically cannot bring myself to do that. So this particular brand that I'm featuring is awesome for a few reasons. I mean, I haven't tried the clothing yet, but I'll explain that in a second. If you do have any suggestions about good brands to try out, please leave them in the comments, because I would love to try out some more. And I will keep on doing my more affordable fashion hauls, because I know some people don't like me doing them because it promotes fast fashion, and I totally understand that perspective, but it's also for those who can't afford these brands that are significantly more expensive. Unfortunately, not everyone has the luxury of being able to spend more money on these kinds of brands. Some people are, actually a lot of people that I know that have messaged me are like living paycheck to paycheck, and unfortunately you don't really have the luxury of being able to spend more on a brand, even if it is more sustainable. So I'm trying to keep everyone happy, which is impossible, but I'm doing my best. This brand is Everlane. I've got a huge box. I think I ended up spending $670, which, bit of a shock to the system, but it's fine because most of this stuff was actually on sale and it looks like really good quality stuff, and I am happy to pay more if I feel confident in the purchase and that I know that it's actually going towards a brand that is making huge steps towards sustainability, is using better quality fabrics, making better quality garments. It's just hard because if I was shopping on some of these other websites, you're literally, I could have bought 3 hoodies for what I bought with this whole haul. Literally like 3, you don't need hoodies, like sweatshirts for $600, like it's really expensive, and I just can't justify that. Okay, also wanted to say, most of this stuff is for winter. I also really, really wanted some nice, that's a problem as well, which is really weird. Some of these sustainable brands, you would think they would steer away from using animal-derived materials like wool. There were such beautiful like knits, but they're all like cashmere or wool, and I don't want to wear that. Even the jeans that I bought, I was looking through the website after I made the purchase, and I noticed that this little patch here on the jeans is leather. Like, why? That's so unnecessary to make. Couldn't you just put vinyl or PU leather, like fake stuff? It's just so strange. That's one bummer, but this stuff that I bought is all the synthetic stuff, so if you're vegan, it should be fine, I think. That's it as well. A lot of these sustainable brands, the models, bless their beautiful souls, are like super tall. So I'm like, oh yeah, that jumper fits perfectly. I would love that jumper. And then she's like 6'10" and I'm 5'4" and I'm like, okay, so that's gonna be like down to my knees on me. So a lot of those brands, they're just too big, too long, made for beautifully tall people, but not for short people. Ooh, that's what I'm talking about. Ooh, and it's fluffy on the inside. I've been wearing, if you watch my cotton on video, I've been wearing those plain tops all day, every day. Those plain sweatshirts, every single second of the day I've been wearing them, and they don't have the fluffy stuff on the inside. So this is awesome that it does. Love the crew neck, feels really good quality. I will list what I bought in the description in chronological order, so I don't have to say the styles out. You can just go straight to the caption. This is a lovely length. It must be cropped. Website was great because it actually showed you, if you're not familiar with Everlane, exactly how much it would cost them. It cost them to make it. Like each individual part of the process, like the fabric, the manufacturing, the labor, which is the same thing, the tags, the freight. It shows you everything, how it's all, like the cost of everything, which really took me by surprise, to be honest, because it's so rare that yeah, it's just so open, so transparent. It really took me by surprise, and I was like, oh, okay. I feel like I was seeing something that I wasn't allowed, like meant to be seeing, but it was amazing. And this is Chef's Kiss. Oh. I mean, I'm wearing a top underneath this too, and these pants aren't probably the best to be wearing it with because they're high-waisted. Mark my words, I'm going on the website and buying more of these if I haven't already bought every single color of this. Beautiful, beautiful. For my short friends that are around 5'4" or 164 centimeters, and you like things to be a little bit more cropped because it just is more flattering on our bodies, this is your jam. I love the off the shoulder. Again, some of the other brands were really traditional sweat tops, so the seam was here and it just gives a bit of a squareness to the body, whereas having it off the shoulder just creates more of a curve. Cuffed at the bottom, plain at the back. Oh, what a great start. So this one is a little bit longer, but that's okay. I think I bought this in every color. Yeah, it says better factories, better quality, better prices. That's our promise. We reveal the story behind every product, from our ethical manufacturing process to our transparent pricing breakdown. This one is in a size extra small. Oh, that's a strange feeling. Ooh. First of all, the first thing I noticed is that you can see how this has got a strange, like, little, I don't know, sewing detail around here. I can feel it. I can feel it when I move. It feels like you've got it on wrong, and it's like, I mean, I'm sure I've, it kind of feels like my bra strap's falling down or something. Kind of annoying, but it's fine. The length is actually, that's what I like about having these cuffs, and then kind of like balloons or kind of over, like a little mushroom, like a muffin top, because then you can, if you like it to be long, you can have it like that. But if you're like me and you like it to be, excuse me, burping my toast up. If you like it to be a little bit higher up, then you just pull it up like that. The back is marginally longer. This has nothing to do with the, ooh, long cuffs. I don't know if you've watched my clothing hauls, but I do love a long cuff. It's just really flattering. I don't know what it is about it. It's just really flattering having a long cuff. This color is nice. Yellow, I would never normally buy, but it was on sale. I wanted to try it all out. Here we are, yellow. Kind of washes me out a little bit, but it's different and I like it. And I like the fit. It's just, yeah, it's nice. I really am stoked with that. I have a few other colors, so let me just speed through those quick. Oh, pretty. I'm gonna have to leave soon and come back because my darling Mia, I booked her in to get her dental, her teeth cleaned and scaled and everything, the scale and polish. So she's under anesthetic and then they checked her teeth and she needed the 13 teeth out. The little incisor ones at the front because her teeth have grown in a weird way and they're all either wobbly or have disease and they don't want it to spread to her canines, which are also growing horizontally rather than vertically. So that's fun, but I was like, when she said 13, I was like, what? But anyway, I'm gonna be picking up her up soon. Oh, this is cute. It's a weird material. It's not like, I think if you got the cashmere one, it would be super soft, but this is beautiful. Surprisingly, I'm actually going to like this little detail. And I kind of like that, even though I just said that sweatshirt's nice because it has off the shoulder, it has an off the shoulder seam. I think this is actually kind of nice the way it is. It kind of just, it's very going to play golf or have high tea or something like that. This pink is more my jam, methinks. Bit of perspective for you. Also regarding sizing, these are pretty true to size. Oh, interesting. Definitely interesting. I just love the fit of these. God, all I can see is just self-inflicted, can't complain. Oh, why does it sit like that? What? Why does it sit all fluffy like, huh? It's got a little saggy butt, this one.
Weird.
I think this is the kind of color that would grow on me, but I'm kind of liking green at the moment. Oh gosh, I've got two more. I mean, you know this is gonna be a winner.
Beautiful.
Oh, I'm gonna be living in this, I tell you that much. It's kind of hard to see because it's obviously black, but oh, I just love this length. Because normally I'd have to tuck these tops in, as you've seen me do a million times like that. And it's fine, but I think it just looks nicer if it can just kind of like hang at the top and it kind of tucks itself in without having to feel like that restriction when you've got something tucked in and you don't want to move too much because it'll pop out. So this is, of course, the same thing, just like a camel. Kind of the same kind of material as the, not material, mixture of color as the green one. It has like the white marbled or veining, that's not the right word, but whatever, throughout it. Yeah, nice. All right, I'm gonna leave it there and I'm going to pick Mimi up and then come back and finish the rest of the haul. So if the lighting has changed a little bit, that is okay. Okay, obviously the lighting is quite different. I didn't realize how long we'd be there for, and the sun has set, I believe. So I'm using artificial light. Mimi is also doing well. She is super sleepy at the moment. But yeah, everything went well. Teeth came out. Bloods are all good. She's a tough little nugget. All right, back on track. So they're jeans. These are the style is the curvy high-rise skinny jeans. I didn't initially have these in my cart. I actually chose the just plain high-rise skinny jeans. The rise is high stretch 25 ankle. I got these because I have a smaller waist and wider hips. So sometimes high-waisted things can either be either the perfect fit or they're too baggy around my waist. And if a company is designing jeans for a certain body shape, I'm gonna buy the ones that fit my body shape. So hopefully these are gonna be good. I do get a bit paranoid buying these because I don't know if they're like for people with super small and wide hips, super small waist and wide hips, but we can only try. It's like normal denim, which I actually don't really like. I prefer the thin, stretchy, kind of like, dare I say, Fashion Nova denim. Ew, I won't even attribute it to them. Like, even like my Kmart jeans are really thin, smooth denim. These are like the traditional, let's say the stretch. I mean, they are stretchy to be fair, but I feel like the other one's a bit more flattering. The thinner fabric. Also not a fan of the pitch black, but the washed black, I think they had a washed black option, was sold out. And I'm not sure if the other colors were sold out, because black's not my first choice, especially like a solid black. They kind of remind me of work pants, but I just wanted to at least buy one that was available in my size. That way I know if I do like them, I can just go back and buy the other colors when they come available. I'm also going to try on, I'm just gonna show you them both beforehand so that when I'm back on screen, you know what's going on. This is the, which is a plain cotton crew, extra small color white. Does look a bit more see-through, but I just love crew neck t-shirts and I find them really hard to find good quality ones. I think this one's probably gonna be too thin, but I also got a black one, so at least I can try both out.
Ooh, okay.
All right, hold up. Hold up. Okay. First things first, the top. Not a fan, to be honest. The fabric is too thin. I mean, you can basically see my bra through it. The sleeves are too long. It looks way better when the sleeves are cuffed. The length is a little bit long. I'll tuck it in. I mean, this is a really rough tuck. I would normally put some effort in. But just to give it, I mean, that looks kind of cute though. I don't mind that. Oh, I look really top heavy. Can you see the jeans? Well, they fit really nicely around the waist. They're definitely snug. They probably have a little bit of a spillage over the side here. But I think once they stretch a bit, that will be ideal, because you don't want them to be the perfect size when you first put them on, because otherwise they will stretch. It's denim, and then they'll be too big. So I'd rather them be a little bit too tight, but you can see that there's a little bit of spillage here. But again, it's stretchy as well, so it's not like uncomfortable. It just feels snug. I do like the fit. I like the high waist. I hate that there's a stupid leather patch. That's unnecessary and really weird from a sustainable brand, because animal products aren't sustainable. Length is great. Right at the ankles. I don't know. I think I'm just so not used to wearing normal denim. Like old school denim. I feel like it's widening or something, because it's thicker. That when you have to sew the two bits of fabric together, it's thicker. It kind of just widens. Oops, jeez, how did I buy it? What's this? Oh no, silly me. Rookie mistake. I got excited and thought, oh, you can't go wrong with basics. So I bought doubles. Doubles are the one thing I don't like as much. Let me try on the black. I'm sure I'll like the black. I hope I'll like the black. I don't know what their returns are like for international customers. The shipping was pretty good, to be honest. Oh, I really don't vibe with these long sleeves. But yeah, I much prefer the black. I mean, black, so you just can't go wrong. And in combination with the jeans, because they are really like sucking me in, it creates a nice silhouette too. And because black is more forgiving, even if you did have a muffin top, you can't really see. That's a nice outfit. I quite enjoy that. The white tops. Perhaps I was quick to judge. The sleeves are actually okay. It's just the white one that I'm not as in love with. What's this little number? Nah. Let's try on something more exciting. What is this? Ooh, this looks a little bit see-through. Soft cotton crew. Oh, is this just the same as the other ones? Wow, I really did buy every color. I thought I'd try them all on, but there's some still hiding apparently. I forgot about those weird seams and I noticed them again. Gosh, it's a strange feeling. This is really nice though. Yeah, definitely, I mean, see-through. Oh, is that a defect? Yeah, the sewing stuffed up a bit there. I don't know, I think I would probably only wear this with a top underneath, because I wouldn't want to be drawing attention to that area. So I hope if I do have something, I mean, that's pretty obvious though, those little lines. If I did have a white top underneath, maybe it wouldn't be as obvious. It's a bit annoying though, because it's like right at the center. Oh wait, I did buy another pair of jeans. Yes, thank you, past Lauren. Well, okay then, let me try those on. What a great surprise. These are really nice. I think this is a bit much. This creasing bit, like I've been sitting for the last 10 years, but I get it, maybe it just adds depth or something. I like the fact that this bit here is a bit lighter, kind of gives shape to the legs, and the shin is just normal. Back's nice. Stupid leather thing. Yeah, the length is perfect again. If you're the same height as me, you will not be disappointed. That's just a cute little outfit. Wow, it's literally nighttime. Crazy. What's this? Ooh, this looks promising. 100% organic cotton. This is what I wanted. Look, it's a really simple boxy tee. But again, hard to find a good length. If you wanted to, you could probably roll these sleeves. Yeah, I actually prefer that when they're rolled a little bit like that. It looks okay too. I just like short sleeves, like crew sleeves. I just feel like it's more flattering. But even like that, out, it's nice. Oh, stoked. I think I only bought one. Yeah, this is not leaving a whole lot to the imagination. I'm bringing obviously a completely opaque bra, so you can't see through it, but the top, definitely this fabric is not. It's nice, it's really comfy. I guess just the thinner fabric, yeah, you are prone to having that transparency, I guess. Whoa. I may, yeah, that's just silly. I won't wear this. That's like worse than Pretty Little Thing. Back in the boxy top. Last thing I bought is a really random one. Very, very random. They're shoes, but they're a special kind of shoe. These are basically rain boots. What are they, gum boots? But fashionable. So you get the practicality of being able to walk in wet, on wet terrain. Muddy terrain, wet terrain, and still look cute, you know? You've got this bit of elastic here. They were pretty reasonably priced too, because normally shoes are, you know, a bit hit and miss with pricing, but what size did I get? I think I got a 38. No, 7. Size 7. Apparently they're hard to get on, so we shall see. But yeah, I just got them so I can walk. If I go for walks outside or something, I don't have to worry about my shoes getting all... Oh wow, these are going to be hard to get on. My shoes getting all dirty. Wait a sec. Ugh. I don't know how I want this on. Ooh, they're like platformy. I feel taller. I am taller. No, this needs to be done sitting down. Yeah. Because I'm wearing socks, because they're rubber, when I pull the boot over my sock, it like pulled my sock super tight. And I can't get my fingers in there because it's like, I mean, you can hear it. My sock's like on my foot. The fit's perfect. They're like the size is perfect. Oh, they look so weird with these jeans. I think I'd actually need like full length jeans or black socks. These are the shoes. Jeans are tight. Get that balance right. This outfit as a whole is a bit... I don't know if I'm vibing the outfit. I feel like these shoes wouldn't get uncomfortable either. They're really comfy. The thick rubber. You'd think that would be like... I don't know. I mean, I haven't worn them for an extended period of time, like 30 seconds at the longest, so... I'm really impressed. All right, let's touch base. Everlane. I'm really impressed. I 1000% shop here again. And I will probably go here for some of my basics. Like more of these tops. More of those. Oh, I bought all the colors. There's no more to buy. Little like sweater tops. The bought that like first black actual sweater, not like little knit sweater that we're buying more of. The jeans, I like them. I won't return them. I'm sure I will wear them, but they're not my favorite pair. I'm wishing that Kmart didn't stop selling them. Even Fashion Nova, I don't know, I'd rather pass. So I'm still on the search for perfect jeans that are the right length and the right fabric. But these are nice. I'm not going to buy any more, I don't think, any more of this particular jean, because the fabric is exactly what it says it is, which is jeans, which is not exactly what I'm after. Yeah, what a great experience. Shipping time was good. It's just been really easy. I guess because I first found Everlane when I was looking at sustainable brands and then looking at other brands afterwards, I guess they really raised the bar, which is a credit to them. So then looking at other brands afterwards, I had high expectations and none of them really met those expectations. So yeah, credit to Everlane for doing a really good job of what they're doing and really obviously sticking to their word and producing good quality stuff, good price, great transparency. I fully recommend them to any of you who are looking for sustainable brands. Really great. And shipping to Australia was totally fine and really reasonable, which I mean, granted, I did spend a lot of money, so perhaps did I get free shipping? I don't know. It was great. I didn't have any complaints, but I did spend a lot. So, I mean, I would hope to have no issues with shipping if I'm spending that money. What a great experience. I hope you enjoyed. Please do leave any recommendations for other sustainable brands in the comments. My voice just broke. But yes, I'll check them out. That's about it. Thanks for watching. I hope you have a great day and I'll see you all in my next video. Bye guys.